Hey there, welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player 2. Today, we're going to take a closer look at Mass Effect, and Mass Effect 2, and 3. But not Andromeda, that's not out yet. The Mass Effect series is rife with topics that would be perfect for Play Noggin: artificial intelligence, futuristic weapons, and extraterrestrial breeding. But for the humans in the game's universe, they would have never been able to meet and mate with blue space ladies if it weren't for the discovery of faster-than-light travel. See, the nearest star to our sun, Proxima Centauri, is over 4 light-years away, meaning light, the fastest thing in the universe, takes 4 years to reach it. Our galaxy is over 100,000 light-years in diameter. If there are other intelligent races spread all across it, we better figure out some way to up the cosmic speed limit if we're going to interact with them. Mass Effect tackles this problem by dealing with mass. Particles of light, called photons, have no mass, but anything with mass, say a nice chunky human or a spaceship, cannot travel at the speed of light. They can get close, but never 100% light speed. That would take more energy than there is available in the universe. To solve this problem in Mass Effect, there's a rare element which, when electricity is applied, creates dark energy which affects the mass of objects in its field. Hey, that's where the name of the game comes from. Most of that explanation is mumbo-jumbo, and worse, reducing your mass to zero is a really terrible way to achieve light speed if you want to get somewhere in one piece. Elementary particles like electrons and quarks have mass because they interact with something called the Higgs field. This field, first hypothesized by Peter Higgs in the 1960s and confirmed with the discovery of the Higgs boson in 2012, is everywhere, so everything is constantly moving through it. Massless particles like photons and gluons, however, do not interact with it, so they're free to zip about at light speed. If you were to counteract the Higgs field somehow, your electrons would become massless and would travel at the speed of light too. You can imagine how this might alter the chemical reactions in your body a bit, but assuming you didn't die from turning chemistry on its ear, you still would be far from massless, because 99% of the mass of your atoms comes not from electrons or the quarks that make up the protons and neutrons in the nucleus, but the energy it takes to bind the quarks together. Remember, energy and mass are related, because E equals mc squared. So, to become truly massless, you'd have to do away with these binding energies too, and as you might have guessed, that's what's holding you together at a subatomic level. No amount of weight loss is worth being torn to shreds. Plus, if your particles were massless, then they still can only travel at the speed of light, but not faster than it. All in all, Mass Effect's solution for breaking the light speed limit is, well, it's terrible. You wouldn't make your date with the blue space lady on the other side of the galaxy because A, it'd take you thousands of years, and B, you'd be a bit of a mess by the time you got there. But if humanity is to travel the stars and spread across the galaxy, we either need to spend centuries traveling in spaceships, like they will in Andromeda. Oh, I can't wait for that game. Or we'll have to find a loophole in the cosmic speed limit that doesn't unravel us at the seams. Thanks for watching Play Noggin. If you like this episode, be sure to like and subscribe. Comment if you have any ideas for any episodes you want to see in the future. And don't forget to keep on playing.